Here we will now have a look at a list implementation of the graph where we store an adjacency list. That means we store for each node the connected nodes. So if node 1 would be connected to nodes 100 and 5000, we just store those two. We will use as an example a dgraph implementation and a dynamic graph. That means we can grow and shrink the graph dynamically as needed. And this fits very well our adjacency list model, because most graphs are actually sparse and need some dynamics to be stored. So we need to store them as linked nodes, which is kind of a list. We use again the single character for now to store the values of a node. And this implementation provides some flexibility of the construction. And what is a graph? Well, it's just a starting node or null if there exists no such node. Let's have a look at the structure. So we have a node. A node has a value. As we know, it has a list of outgoing edges, which is our adjacency list. And it has connection to the next node if there exists any. And we store our graph as an additional list of nodes, such that we can always traverse a graph even though it has no potential edges. And the graph is just a node in this example. So what we need to do is, when we want to add an edge from a source to a target node, we push into the list as an outgoing edge our target as information. That's all we need to do. When we add a node, we try to add it upfront on our global graph list. Here we use a double pointer to replace the graph list. It avoids that we have to use this kind of sentinel node that we had for our lists and our tree, where we had to remember, was the initial node empty or not. We know basically a graph that is null is basically empty. So what we use here, when we add a node, we use a double pointer because we change this kind of pointer here. We have to allocate a new node. We set initialize this node to 0 using memset again. Now we initialize an outgoing list using list init, which we have written before. We assign the value, and now if graph would not be null, then we know we have to set the node next to be basically wherever graph points to. And once we are done, we update this graph node with our current node. So it is a bit like a linked list plus additional information. Here we use now our API to define a graph. A graph is now initially null, and now we can add nodes. So we take graph, which is this initial node, and we update it. We have to figure out the address using our address of operator. So we update this pointer, and we put initially A, then we add the node B, we add the node C, and we add the node dot, and we get nodes A, B, C, and D for dot. Now we can add some edges. So between A and B, we add an edge, between A and D, B and C, D and C, and D and A. So at the end, the graph list itself will look as follows. Graph, yeah, this graph pointer here will point to this node with dot, then to C, to B, A, and finally this will point to null. But we have also stored those edge information, so we get our resulting graph.